Turing TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Mathematics Form 3, lesson number 8. The topic it is Approximation and Errors. I'm your tutor, Lucy Modern. Welcome. Let us look at the lesson goals. The lesson goals, today we are going to look at the squares and square roots using the calculator. How do we get the squares? How do we get the square root using the calculator? Then number two, we are going to look at how we find the cubes and cube roots of numbers using the calculator. So the first thing it is finding the squares and square roots. But we first of all get the squares of numbers. In the calculator, we have the key where we have x squared, and we also have the square root key are presented. They are in the foreign words. The way you can get them, it is x squared. One key, it is written x squared. Then we also have the square root. The x squared, it is used to find the square root of numbers, where the root is used to find the square root of numbers. Let us take examples. We have a number there which you are supposed to find the square. That is the 46 squared. You're supposed to get the 46 squared. So what do we do? We just press the calculator 46. Then we go to the key, which is written as x squared. Press it. After that, then all that will be displayed after having the key equals. It will be displayed with the answer. Where we get it is 2,944. So with that case, now we get the answer as 2,944. So that is the way you're supposed to get it. Then we go to the next one, that is still the squares. We have a number there which is -429 squared. How do you get the square? The square. So step number one, it is pressing the negative. We open the bracket, you press the negative 429, close the bracket, hand the key x squared, then equals. Then the answer will be displayed on the screen, which is 184,041. That is the answer. So when we talk about the squaring of numbers, remember the law of integers still apply. Even when you are using the calculator, negative times a negative, it becomes a positive. That is the reason as to why you can get my negative 429 when it is squared, we are getting a positive answer. We still have another number there that you are required to get the square root. We have 89,361. We are required to get the square root of the number. So what we do, the first gate is getting the root key. Press the root key. Then after root key, we key in the number 89361. After that, equals. The answer will be displayed on the screen, which is 291.93 as the answer. So that is the way you are required to find the square root. First of all, I've said for the square root, get the root sign. Then from there, you just go to the number you are required to find the square. And then you are going to get the answer. Then we go to the cubes and cube roots. In the calculator, there are the two keys. That is x cubed and cube root. Keys are presented. How do we get them? the way they are, x cubed, it is used to find the cubes of numbers. While the cube root is used to find the cube root of numbers. That is the way they are found in the calculator. So what should we do? We just get the negative 341. We have an example there, negative 341 cubed. So when we press the key negative, then 341, then the x cubed. Remember this one, we are starting with a negative, then the value, then x cubed. Step 4 equals, the answer will be displayed on the screen, which is negative 39,651,821. That is the way it is. And remember still, the laws of integers are upright. Negative times negative times negative. That will answer you get it is negative. That is the reason as to why the screen of the calculator is supposed to give you a negative answer. Then let us look at the another number. We have 64 raised to power that. Using the indices, this is the same as cube root of 64. So when using the calculator, you just press the shift. Remember the cube root, it is not a key, but you need to press the shift, then the cube. That is the way you're supposed to do. After that, key in 64. After keying in 64, then equals, the answer will be displayed. The answer become 4. So that is the way the cube root are found in the calculator. This is the activity for today. You are required to evaluate using the calculator square root of the number 693 times 31 divided by 44,670. And the next one, it is, there is a number in bracket which is 536 divided by 437 times 620, then raised to power that. For more information, you can get from the KEB 2003 Secondary Mathematics Students Book 3, that edition. If at all you want to get us, for more information, contact us through an SMS, through the YouTube, through the Facebook, through the Twitter, so you can get us through the four ways. Otherwise, stay tuned to Erim TV.